Oh. Now we're essential. Wow. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I know I have been gone for a while, like a smooth long time, you feel me? But you know, life happens. Like I keep saying, life happens. I opened up this business. I've really been trying to get this off the floor. If you guys seen a few weeks ago, I posted a video talking about how I opened up my lash business. Honestly, it's been doing really well, but that's not why I'm here today. We are talking about working as an RT through this pandemic. A lot of my family members keep sending me like little like snippets and snippets and snippets of like different things happening, and I'm like, I know, I'm there. But you know what, a lot of people are not realizing, like what I feel like, since I like when I get on my Facebook and I see like high school friends and stuff talking about like, don't let them tell you what to do, like go out in the streets if you want to go out in the streets, and it's like, bruh, no. Like, honestly, like, working through this pandemic has showed me, like, I gotta let go of some of my old friends. They're stupid. That, you know what, at the end of the day, like, we're out here risking our lives every day, okay, on the regular. Then you put forth this pandemic that is happening right now. One, there's not enough of us. There's not enough hospital staff to take care of the amount of people that are coming in that are sick. There's definitely not enough RTs out here to manage the vents, nor are there enough vents to go around. They just don't understand what it's like to see somebody take their last breath. That's the only thing that I can like, that's the only thing that I can think that people don't understand, why this is like so like huge, why this is so important for them to follow, you know, the rules and all the orders that are being put into place. It's not to monitor you or censor you or to stop any of that. It's to really keep you safe, because people like me, when I come home at night, I come home to my husband and my three kids and my dog. Do you think that I want to stay at work to take care of you because you decided to lick a toilet seat, or because you decided to go out and go for a job or go to Disneyland or to go to SeaWorld because you don't, you just have no regard for anybody? Sorry, rambling. Y'all know I like to ramble. But anyways, but in all seriousness, do you think that, you know, we want to risk our lives and our families' lives and safety and health, you know, just because? Do you think that we're out here on the main lines, front lines, picketing, trying to get more supplies because we're trying to censor what you're doing? We could care less what you do in your life. We could honestly care less. And the norm, and like, and normal life, when none of this shit affects us, you know, your day-to-day life does not affect us. We do not care what you're doing. But right now, while we are in a state of emergency, while healthcare providers are out here risking their lives to help your family or to help you, and you decided to go on spring break knowing the risks, it bothers us. It fucking bothers me. Because at the end of the day, there's not enough supplies. There are not enough of us. There's not enough. And when I go back to talking about, like, you know, we're having to learn a lot of these things on the fly. The other day I was watching this doctor from, I want to say that it was Portland, Oregon. And she was an ER doctor, and she had came up with this idea to ventilate one patient or four patients on one vent. I have never seen this. I'm not saying that it's not possible. I'm just saying that I've been an RT for a year. I went to school for 2 years. I read in and out about the different molds and ventilation and different vents, and I've worked with different vents, and I have never heard of, you know, ventilating more than one person on a vent, right? But to attempt to ventilate four people, if I know how to do this, I will post a picture over here that's showing like this vent, and it's crazy because because they have like they have tubing connected to the exhalation port, the inhalation port, and then on top of those two ports, then that streams down from the sides of them. Then they have the Y adapters, and then they have the corrugated tubing going off to the side to ventilate two and two. My thing is, like, how are we supposed to, like, vents are very hard, you know, learning them. And to try to learn this whole new system on the fly, I just don't see that working out well. I really don't, okay? Also, like, settings, like, what the fuck? How are you gonna set these settings? Like, everyone's lung compliance is different, right? So how am I supposed to manipulate this vent to this patient when I'm supposed to be manipulating this vent to four patients who have all different lung compliance, who have all different, you know, like body sizes, and like these people are like, they're not like the same patient, you know, like four of the same identical patients on this vent. There are four of the same patients with the coveted 19. That's what's gonna be on it. It's not saying, that's crazy to me that they think that that's gonna work. And correct me if I'm wrong, drop an article or, you know, a link, something telling me how y'all are going, how we are supposed to manage these vents with these patients. I wanna know.
This came out after I was editing the video from the AARC saying that we are not going to be using this situationship.
If I just missed something or whatever, like, let me know, because I have never heard of this. But, you know, a lot of hospitals are getting to a point where there's not enough vents. So they are gonna have to start making the hard decision of who lives and who dies. So that being said, you know, for the people who are out here that are like, I'm doing whatever I want to do because it's my life and I'm gonna do it. God forbid your grandmother gets sick, and she comes in, and then somebody who's 30 years old comes in, okay? Your grandmother is 86 years old. This person is 30 years old who still has a whole life to live. Do you think that they're going to pick the 86-year-old grandmother over this 30-year-old patient? They're not. They're going to pick the 30-year-old patient because that person has a longer life expectancy than this person. So when it comes down to like us having to choose who lives and who dies, that's concerning. That's worrisome. That's why we're trying to stop and flatten the curve before it gets to the point where healthcare providers are playing, you know, God. So my PSA to you guys, stay the fuck in the house, okay? Stay the fuck in the house. We don't want to see you in the ER, you know, because you've been out at Disneyland and stuff. And I'm not even trying to be offensive, but I'm just letting you know, we're motherfucking tired.
She like, cash, bitch, you doing too much. I'm like, shut up, ho, you ain't doing.